So you want to add terpenes to your THC product. Well, how much terpenes do you use? Well, that's called the dilution ratio. My name is Drew, owner of MrExtractor.com, and I'm here today to tell you the truth about what dilution ratio you should be using in this week's episode, Terpene Dilution Ratios, from the Terpene Institute. So you want to start mixing terpenes in your product and you don't know how much to use and your products are expensive and you don't want to mess it up. I totally got that. All right. So what I'm going to do is there's a whole bunch of different products that you can mix terpenes with. And I want to do a video on every single one. I'm going to give you a tutorial, whether you already make products or you're just thinking about it, on how to make every single different product with our terpenes. But the fact is, I just don't have time right now. So I'm going to give you a basic understanding on how much you should use with all different products, and I'll skim through it, and hopefully this gets you going, and later you can watch a full tutorial on each individual product. I'll just give you a walkthrough on how to make it, sell it, knock yourself out, all right? So one of the main things that people are doing right now is they're taking our terpenes and they're mixing them with distillate and they're making a vapor pen. So how much do you wanna use? Now, always, every batch of distillate is gonna be different, and all terpenes are a little bit different, but they're all pretty much the same. So I tell everybody, no matter how professional you are, no matter how big you are, no matter how small you are, you always want to do a small batch first. If you have 1,000 grams of distillate and a big jar of terpenes, don't just mix the two together, because if you blow it, then you're screwed. Start with the 1 gram batch, get your ratio. I do that on every product I ever make, and so do large companies. Small batch testing, that's the term for it. So what I recommend is that, well, first off, you need to understand that the ratio between terpenes and your product is going to differ every single time, because your distillate will always come out a different viscosity, and it depends on what pen you use. Every different pen and cartridge that you use has different hole sizes in there and burns differently, and it likes a specific viscosity that it works best at. Know your cartridge first and make a few different samples and see which one actually tastes best and smokes with the biggest clouds in the cartridge that you're using, and then don't switch, because you're going to have to do it all over every single time. So basically, with distillate, you want to start out at 10% of terpenes. Now, you take your distillate, say you got 100 grams of distillate, 10 grams of terpenes. Now, you're going to want to mix that. Heat does help. The smallest amount of heat, quickly mix it and make sure it emulsifies all together. Now, if you heat something at a low temperature for a long time, it darkens. I've personally found that if I heat it high really quickly and stir it and then cool it down, I have less darkening, because it's really like a baking effect, in my opinion. High heat doesn't always like instantly flash it. Everyone's got a different opinion on it. So whatever you do, you have to heat it up a little bit, make sure that it emulsifies in and take the heat away from it. And then you want to let it cool down to room temperature, because your client is going to be using that pen at room temperature. You want to put it in the pen while it's still warm, check your pen at room temperature, not hot. See how the bubble moves, see how it smokes. And if I were you, I'd make a couple different pens at different rates and find out what works best for your pen. Like I said, it's gonna be different. There's a million types of pens out there. You may live in Arizona where everything's 100 degrees. You may live in Alaska. You're gonna wanna make it a little runnier in Alaska and a little thicker in Arizona. So all custom work here. So you've mixed in 10%. This works great. It's probably not gonna be too runny. I can pretty much guarantee that. But if it's too thick still, then you can just add a little bit more terpenes and stir it in. Being that the terpenes have already emulsified in your distillate, you don't need to reheat it at that point. It will mix in just by hand, just fine. Now, if you've made it too thin, add more distillate in there, stir it back up until you've got it the right way. You'll never really ruin a batch if you're doing that. Ballpark ratios for distillate, 10 to 15% is what we recommend. Now, like I said, we work out of Los Angeles. We supply some of the largest pen companies in the country down in Los Angeles, and we always talk with their R&D teams. What they're finding is you can get the amount of terpenes to make it function in the pen, but customers are actually just liking more flavor. They just really want to taste some things, and that's what we're just seeing across the board. Always work with what your clients want, because that's your main goal, not what you want. Nobody really cares what you like. Just remember that. You got to keep it in perspective. You may be the owner of a company. Nobody cares. Customers want what they want, so make sure to give them choices and let them choose. You know, it's one of the fallacies that we all have as manufacturers, that everybody thinks like us. So give them a few options. Let them choose if they want a more flavorful pen or a less flavorful pen, cannabis profiles, flavored profiles, whatever. Remember, 10 to 15% is a ballpark. In Los Angeles, in the major areas, we are finding that they like a little bit more terpenes for a more robust flavor in their pen. Distillate tastes like crap anyway. I think it tastes like plastic, and I don't like the taste of it. I'd rather have a little more flavoring, a little weaker pen, and take an extra hit of something I liked than one less hit of something that I don't. Now, when you're dealing with shatter and hard extracts, you have to remember there's a window here, a scale. You've got liquefied oil down here. You've got solid shatter over here. You are taking either end of this spectrum, and you're trying to get it into a liquid. Obviously, this oil over here is closer to a liquid already, so all you have to do is add a little bit of terpenes. If you're over here in a solid state, you're going to have to add more terpenes. So on the hardest shatter we've ever seen, just like some glass, the most we've ever had to add was 50% by weight. Cool thing about my products, which makes them better than other people's products, is other companies give you a max dilution ratio of 5 to 8% because they do not know how to blend their terpenes. Watch my other videos on how to blend terpenes and why our products are better scientifically. Our products will taste fine at 50%. You try doing that with another company, your throat's gonna get all jacked up because they don't know how to do it. They're just reading a piece of paper from a lab. We don't do that. We handcraft our blends so that regardless of what product you're using, it's gonna taste good and it's gonna taste the same and it's not gonna be harsh. So for BHO, some solid shatter, you're gonna wanna use up to a 50% ratio. We can pretty much guarantee that all of our products will taste good at up to a 50% ratio, and it's kind of unheard of. Other companies require the use of MCTs or polyethylene glycol as a cutting agent. I don't like it. It's not how we developed our product. So 1 gram of BHO shatter to, what would that be? Half a gram. Now our terpenes are about 48 drops per gram. So if you don't have a scale and you have a gram of shatter, what is that, 24 drops? We'll liquefy that down. So what about waxes and crumble? Well, that's just in the middle of the scale. So, you know, you've got 10% over here, 50% over here, your wax and your crumbles are gonna be at about 25 to 30%. Those things usually come out foggy when you stir them up. If you have an extract and you mix some terpenes and it's kind of foggy, hit it with a little heat. Those are your waxes that are showing. The waxes loosen up, they melt, and then they emulsify themselves back in there and then it stays clear. It's a really cool process. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do demo videos on each one of these. I'm gonna take some distillate, I'm gonna mix it, I'm gonna show you the differences in everything. I'm gonna take some BHO and mix it, teach you how to do all that at another time. Right now, I've just got a lot on my plate. So hopefully these basic ratios help you out in your products, and go try it out. Start with the small batch always, make sure it functions at room temperature always, scale yourself up. There's companies out there making millions of dollars that started in their garage, and so can you, all right? So thanks for watching. The Terpene Institute was created just to give you a simple common sense understanding of terpenes and the cannabis industry, make some money, help some people, trying to help you guys out, all right? Thank you for watching. Go to MrExtractor.com and I will see you in the next episode. Take it easy.